Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, I'm going to use Abbyy Finereader 16 to convert a PNG image to an editable document. But before we get to that, please take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. This is the PNG file that I have. It is a screenshot of what looks to be a table with several different rows and columns, in addition to using checkbox images. And I want to get this into an editable document. So the first thing I'm going to do is select OCR editor. Then I'm going to open up the screenshot PNG. And Abbyy is going to automatically run OCR on the image. Let's zoom in on the image panel and take a peek at our text panel. So the first thing I noticed right away is that Abbyy didn't do a great job at recognizing this as a table. So I'm going to right click in the image panel and I'm going to delete all areas of text. Next, I'm going to use the table tool to drag a box around this table. And then I'm going to use the option called Analyze Table Structure. And it's very hard to see. It's in the bottom corner of this window. And when I do that, it tries to apply the rows and columns for this table. It did a pretty good job, and it even merged the cells on the very top. So this is great. Next, what I can do is select the Recognize button, and it attempts to OCR the file, and it does a decent job. Currently, I'm actually recognizing it in English. I need to change this from English to Spanish, and then I'm going to recognize again. And let's see if that does any better. It does appear to have fixed it a little bit. We only have a couple of low confidence characters, and I'm just going to visually spot check that this is accurate. And it appears to be accurate. Now, the other component here is that it changed the icons. This is because I used a table zone in the image panel, and it's trying to OCR it. So what we can do instead is we can actually type something in this box. Now, I don't know Spanish very well. I believe that this says specifications. So what I want to do, I'm going to do a quick Google search on how to translate meets specification. And this is the translated text that I got. Now the problem is it made it ginormous. So let's see if we can get it a little bit small. I'm going to copy and paste it from Notepad. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to paste in place of all of these cells that have the copyright symbol, because I'm going to have an issue finding those checkboxes with the right character encoding. All right, so I am simply pasting the meets specifications in Spanish in all of these cells. Now what I want to do is I'm going to change my export settings to searchable PDF, and then I'm going to save this file out as a PDF. Ooh, all right. So I have my image exported out as a PDF file. Now, a couple of things that I first noticed, the accessibility on this is fantastic. We actually have several cells in here where we have the meets specifications. I realize now I should probably, in the cells that it fails, put the words does not meet specifications, but all of my table rows came through. The problem is the image is really blurry. Now, this might be a situation that I don't know if there's a whole lot I can do to fix this. Unfortunately, scanned images just do not come through very good, but we can try to adjust some of those settings. So let's go back to our searchable document here. And the next thing I would do is try to edit some of the exporting settings. So to do that, I'm going to select Tools, Options, go to my PDF, and right now I have Image Quality set to Best Quality. I might instead do something like Custom, and I'm going to make it to where there's no change in image color and no quality loss allowed, and select OK. And I'm just validating some of my other settings. I'm going to select OK. And for this example, I could write in here, does not meet specifications. And all this does is this applies it on the layer under. So it's not going to actually display these words, but it will display it in the cell. All right, so let's go ahead and save out a new copy of this same file and see if we get any better results. All right, well, it still looks pretty blurry to me. Let's try one other thing. So in my tools options area, I have an option for applying MRC compression and precise scan. I'm going to deselect the precise scan and try to figure out if this fixes anything. So I disabled the precise scan and now I'm going to save out a new copy. Still looks a little blurry to me, but again, I don't know that there's much that we do here. Let's go into the settings one more time. This time I'm going to deselect the MRC compression completely and select OK. Then let's save this file out one more time. Hey, that's looking a little better. So I removed the smoothing for MRC compression, and now it appears that my text came through appropriately, and we have the different cells in here, and it also has my alternate text. Not my alternate text, but it replaces the behind the screen text for this particular icon. Now, if we wanted to do some other things with this file, we could save it out as a Microsoft Word document instead. But the difference with this is that it is going to include those different alternate texts because of the way I zoned it in Abbyy. But this still gives us a good text-based file. If I needed all of the checkboxes to come through, I would need to actually tag this a bit different. I would need to apply picture zones to these cells instead. But the way that Abbyy works, you can't have layers on top of each other. So you would have to manually do those icons and then reinsert them as a table. You just learned how to take a PNG file that's a rather poor quality and convert it into a PDF document that you can edit or into a Microsoft Word document that you can edit. As always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.